Folks, Paul Notice here, writer and creator of Willow, and I am here to show you just one of the many rewards we have to offer in our crowdfunding campaign, a dream analysis. Why am I giving a dream analysis as a reward? What is Willow? Who are you? You ask a lot of questions, and I will answer them all in reverse. Who are you? I'm Paul Notice, executive producer of Notice Blog. I'm an Emmy Award-winning producer, director, with over a decade of experience who's working with a team of other experienced and talented directors. Shoshana Chowdhury, Katrina Reid, and Pierre Jean Gonzalez. What is Willow? Willow is an Afrofuturist, anti-capitalist, womanist, horror flick that takes place in an alternate reality where people literally feed on the weak in order to survive. But after centuries of white supremacists feeding on black and indigenous people, the tables have finally turned. At a price. Why am I giving a dream analysis as a reward? The entire story of Willow starts and ends with an image from a dream that the main character, the aforementioned titular Willow, begins her journey by having a dream that she has been told she cannot have. In this world, if you're not an eater, then you don't have the ability to dream. And yet, Willow discovers in the first moment of that film that she can dream. And she sets out throughout the entire movie to make that dream, that moment, a reality. That's a metaphor for this mythology Americans use to justify capitalism or to justify exploitation, that those who take the most are the only ones with real, true dreams or aspiration. You know, not wanting to be the richest artist, the most paid artist, is something that's not valued. Anyway. And as a writer, I love dreams. I think they're beautiful ways to describe motivation, to give a complex layering of the person's backstory and where they come from. And honestly, I think dreams are just fun. They're always wacky and weird, and anyone can be right about interpreting them. So, in the same spirit as that, I'm gonna offer free dream interpretation. Anyway, before I go on, I just need you folks to do something for me. Go to bit.ly/Willow. I don't know if it reads this way or reads this way. And just contribute what you can. Share. Follow it. Click, 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 click. That's them clicking. They're like, oh my goodness, it's such a great project. Click, click, click. I give you like $100. I don't know. Boom, boom. That's enough time. Thank you so much. I appreciate you. Let's go on to this reward. Why not show you what you came here for, which is a dream analysis. Now. Thank you. For one, and for your entertainment, I shall now give you the dream analysis.
What you're about to see is a dream analysis, but just imagine that on IGTV. Just imagine all of this without all the editing stuff. It's just a live feed of me doing the dream analysis. I'm gonna rehearse it and everything, definitely, because I'm an actor and performer. How dare you think that I'm not gonna rehearse it? But all these graphs and stuff, no. That's how I feel better. Enjoy!
Hey, what's up? This is Balibu Slam. Check out my show, The Real Review. Movie reviews for independent black film. Go to my channel on YouTube. Just type in Malibu Slam and subscribe. I'll see you then.
So, reckless.
There's so much going on, so much that we go through. You for the culture.
Oh, so reckless.
There's so much going on, so much that we go through. You for the culture. This show is just for you. Watch Michaela try to find a way, trying to survive in a bay. But it's a new challenge every day. And reckless behavior.
Stay tuned to the saga.
And reckless behavior.
Bring us on through. Everyone can relate.
And reckless behavior.
Hey, 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 hey.
And reckless behavior.
Hey, 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 hey.
Oh, yeah.
Reckless behavior.
And reckless behavior.
Forever anyway.
Release yourself, let go. Release yourself.
As I sit here meditating up in outer space, my mind randomly wanders out to many different places. Wonder why I'm still here, wonder why I'm not dead. So close I came before to take it two in the head. I guess the Lord had mercy on me, because Slack had a lot to see. Besides ladies in my life, I got babies in my life, and now I gotta stop, look, and listen. I'm wishing for a large amount of cash, just come fast. I know I'm gonna last, I know I'm gonna last. Life just digging in my back every day, getting harder and harder. I'm looking for my pay. When the night falls, I get devious. Some of the things I do, I don't believe it. The temperature's rising, it's driving me crazy. My daughter is away from me, that shit is just killing me slowly. The blood drains from my heart. A soul that was light has now become dark. So I bust caps with no conscience. My victims get the brunt of my anger. Damn, total stranger.
Release yourself, let go. Release.
Damn, yourself. I should've just let it
release
go.
Release yourself, let go. Release.
I should've
yourself.
Let it go. In my dreams, really nightmares. I hear their screams, I say my prayers. So much blood on my hands for all the wrong reasons. Karma catches up in the appropriate season. So much hate, I got so much pain. I'm so tired, I'm so drained. My brain is swelling, the heat is getting thicker. At the end of the tunnel, I see a light flicker. Is it the light of eternity? Or is it the light that's watching over me? Well, I don't know, but I still don't budge. Keeping my distance, I hold on to this grudge. And I plan, and I plot. All good things are forgotten. The violence in me overtakes my actions. I lash out of rage for a moment's satisfaction. Now a human life is erased, and all I can remember is his face. Blinking and thinking, I'm in a cold sweat as I escalate and I contemplate. I look back to the moment when I made that choice, just fueling the fire with evil desires, ignoring my inner man instead of taking a stand. And now my soul is hollow. What about tomorrow? I should've released myself, I should've let it go. Should've thought before I squeezed on the tray. H.O. as somebody's son, as somebody's daddy. 6 feet deep, slowly it creeps into my interior. I just can't take it. I try to look happy, but I just can't fake it. I look into my eyes for the very last time. I take my last life for the very last time.
Release yourself, let go. Release yourself,
let
it go. Release yourself, let go. Release yourself,
just let it go.
Release yourself, let go.
Yourself,
let go, release yourself, let go,
release yourself,
let go,
release yourself,
let go,
go.
It's time for the lightning round! This is the lightning round. The lightning round consists of 7 questions, 30 seconds in total to answer, and no more than 3 seconds per question. Now, if you have all the rules, let's play the lightning round! Back to you, Melville Slim!
Ready to go?
Okay.
Outdoor shoot or indoor shoot?
Outdoor.
Movie short or full-length film?
Full-length film.
All right, pancakes or waffles?
Waffles.
Favorite sex symbol movie star?
Angelina Jolie.
DSLR or GoPro?
GoPro.
Chicken dinner or seafood?
Ooh, gosh, chicken dinner.
Oh, I'm not going to touch that one at all. All right. Thong or lace panties?
Thong.
Okay, now this is a yes or no question. Can I pick you up at 8 tonight?
No. No.
Okay. Well, hey, you know.
No.
Hey, a guy's got to try. All right, well, that's it for the lightning. What's that?
I said I have work in the morning, but
wait a minute. Okay, well, we might have a little something to learn. All right, well, we'll talk about that off camera. But that's it for the lightning round. And that concludes the lightning round.
To me, is a man who was a ladies' man, a womanizer, a Don Juan, a paramour, a lounge lizard. I mean, somebody whose main interest in life would be seducing women.
The reason why my relationships don't work
is because I don't trust you.
I don't trust you. Es porque no te creo.
Trust any woman.
I'm afraid of being hurt. Most of you don't seem to recognize that fact.
I feel just as bad if I'd struck out with everyone in the bar.
I cry myself to sleep at night because you've become cold and distant.
Is a love that sometimes arises after sensual pleasure. If it does, it is immortal. The other kind lies in mere fantasy. Giacomo Casanova.
We should have shotguns with this kind of deal.
How many up there?
3 or 4.
That's counting our guy?
Not you.
So that means it could be up to 5 guys up there?
It's possible.
We should have fucking shotguns. What's her name?
Mia.
Mia. How do Marcellus and her meet?
I don't know. However people meet people. She used to be an actress.
Oh, really? Did she do anything out of scene?
I think her biggest deal was she starred in a pilot.
Pilot? What's a pilot?
Well, you know the shows on TV?
I don't watch TV.
Yeah, but you are aware that there's an invention called television, and on this invention they show shows, right?
Yeah.
Well, the way they pick TV shows is they make one show. That show's called a pilot. Then they show that one show to the people who pick shows, and on the strength of that one show, they decide if they want to make more shows. Some get chosen and become television programs. Some don't, become nothing. She starred in one of the ones that became nothing.
We should have shotguns for this kind of deal.
How many guys are up there?
3 or 4.
Is that counting our guy?
Not sure.
So there could be 5 guys up there.
It's possible.
We should have fucking shotguns. What's her name?
Mia.
Mia? How did her Marcellus meet?
Oh, I don't know how people meet. She used to be an actress.
Oh, really? Anything I'd ever seen?
Well, I think she starred on a pilot.
A pilot? What's that?
Well, you know the shows they show on television?
Well, I don't watch television.
Well, you are aware that there's an invention called television, and on this invention they show TV shows, right?
Yeah.
Well, the way they pick TV shows is they pick one show and they call it a pilot. Now, they show this pilot to the people who pick shows, and on the strength of this pilot, the show is either going to make it or it's not going to make it. She was on one of the shows that didn't make it. This is The Real Review, and I am Malibu Slim. Here at The Real Review, I interview black filmmakers and put their films on display for the world to see. Now, if you have an independent film or even a project or any kind of work that you have put together, I can get it on display. And also, we have a Facebook group called the Black Filmmakers Network. Are you looking to get your project exposure? Well, you came to the right place. Monday, Wednesday, and Friday Pacific time, I have a live podcast and I give interviews twice a week. You can get your project reviewed and I'll also give you a free movie trailer if you don't have one. Come join the Real Review family. We're all black filmmakers and we're a growing community. All I ask from you now is to subscribe. To book yourself on the show, email me at MalibuSlimFilms@gmail.com and put requesting review in the subject bar.
First dream we have up is from Damon Locks. He's an old friend of mine from Chicago who is a visual artist, a DJ, a musician, and an educator. So, Damon agreed to have his dream read out loud to you. He made that sacrifice for you, dear reader. And I shall read, starting now. I hope this object never teeth. Shall we begin? Paul, you were in a dream I had 2 nights ago. I was in the backseat of a car, and both the driver and the passenger were the same person. It was the actor that played Chang from that one TV show, Community. But well, I was giving them both directions to drop you off where you're staying, but nothing looked familiar. Even though it was my hometown and Google Maps wasn't working, I was still very stressed trying to get you where you need to be without letting everyone know that I had no idea where I was going. I love that dream. I mean, that is a beautiful way to describe a lot of things that go on in the world. A lot of times people look to us as Black artists and creators. And obviously Damon is someone who is very big and well known in Chicago and in the country. A lot of people look to us for direction, guidance in our own lives, not just for artists, honestly, for anyone. There's a certain type of anxiety that comes from looking at the tools and measurements you usually look to in order to give the right directions and guidance people seek, and finding that the tools are not how you left them. They're a little bit out of whack. Something's wrong, something's off. The usual solutions or the usual path has been blocked some way. I can imagine that gives a lot of anxiety, especially when people are depending on you to provide something that may benefit their lives. I would venture to say that this is perhaps one of those moments in your life where people are looking for you, as they often do, for the answers. And whether correctly or incorrectly, you believe that you may not have them the same way that you had before. So, what's my analysis for Damon's dream? A complex, shock-induced imposter syndrome. Damon, you are great, and you do have the answers. And when you don't, who gives a fuck? Yeah. Just make them up as you go along. I shouldn't have said that last part, but you know what? I'm not a professional. Oh yeah, sorry. I'm totally not a professional psychiatrist or dream analyzer or whatever, but if I was writing this, I would definitely make that the motivation behind that dream. Anyway, folks, thank you so much for joining us. This is the Dream Analysis. Yeah! Thank you for taking the moment to listen to me ramble and make things up on the spot for your entertainment, for you. If you want more of these dream analysis, if you like good narratives, if you like meaty, delicious rolls that you can sink your teeth into, these meat metaphors, I don't know why I'm doing them today. If you want a wild, Afrofuturist, anti-capitalist, womanist horror flick to be on the big screen coming to you, or most likely on the small online screen still coming to you, then contribute now. Support us now. Follow that link right up there or down below in the description. It is bit.ly/willowhorror. Share this video, this link, with as many people as you like and love. And one more thing, every contribution is tax deductible. Thanks to sponsorship from the Nose Foundation, which specializes in centering narratives with perspectives and stories from marginalized communities. We need contributions from you and people like you to help make this a reality. I have all the faith in the world that we will meet this goal and then some because of that type of generosity. Thank you for joining us, and I'll see you around. I'm just acting like I'm doing things as everything goes, and just cue the credits. Ha! Cool. Yay!
So, you want to make a movie? Introducing MovieGo. Go to MovieGo on Instagram, check out the IGTV tab, and look at the content. Found a favorite actor or director? Good. Next, pick your players. Touch actors. Reach out. And repeat as needed. Need a director? Reach out again. There, it's that easy. MovieGo has everything you need to produce your short film, from costume designers and makeup artists to videographers and editors. What are you waiting for?
Hey ladies, it's time for the Man Raffle, Frank and Sammy's first annual to be exact, hosted by me, Frank and Sammy, and Boney Baby. Don't be ashamed, ladies. Come on down and pay for your man. It ain't tricking if you got it, baby. It's Frank and Sammy's first annual Men Raffle, where you can get a man that's pre-screened by me, Frank and Sammy, baby!
And with Frankensemi's seal of approval, you can rest assured that all the chaps are disease-free. They all have jobs of some form of income, from Macintosh to Mickey D's, baby. Don't be picky. They have their own weed sack and you don't even have to buy. And none of Frankensemi's lads live with their mother. And each and every one of my pseudo-suitors possesses their own vehicles, baby. That's right. No more pissed off days waiting for this broke son of a bitch to arrive late at your job to pick you up in your own car, baby. But wait, there's more, baby. All of Frank and Sammy's men raffle gyms put the toilet seats down. They even open doors and pick up the tab with no jibber jabber. And ladies, most important of all, none of Frank and Sammy's gyms are on the goddamn down low, so you never have to come home and find Harold mixing the salad with Gerald on your own bed sheet. So what are you waiting for, ladies? Come on down before they're all gone, and let's get started with the Men Raffle. Log on to www.malibuslim.com now and register and get your number before they're all gone, baby. Shaboyoyoing, baby. It's the Men Raffle.
This is The Rare Review, and I am Malibu Slim. Here at The Rare Review, I interview black filmmakers and put their films on display for the world to see. Now, if you have an independent film or even a project or any kind of work that you have put together, I can get it on display. And also, we have a Facebook group called the Black Filmmakers Network. Are you looking to get your project exposure? Well, you came to the right place. Monday, Wednesday, and Friday Pacific time, I have a live podcast and I give interviews twice a week. You can get your project reviewed and I'll also give you a free movie trailer if you don't have one. Come join the Real Review family. We're all black filmmakers and we're a growing community. All I ask from you now is to subscribe. To book yourself on the show, email me at MalibuSlimFilms@gmail.com and put requesting review in the subject bar.
Job. You are paid to do this, so go do it. Do it now. It's no different from any other job. Go. Just open the door and shoot her. Shoot her now.
Can I just keep this on?
Sure.